Let's analyze the phenomena of beats by principle of superposition of waves. As we have just now discussed that beats are produced when two waves of a slightly different frequency superpose. So, let these superposing waves are, if we consider two waves as y1 is equals to a sine of 2 pi n1t and y2 is equals to a sine of 2 pi n2t. Here n1 and n2 are the two frequencies which are very close to each other. And in this situation, if we superpose the two waves on a medium particle, here you can see I have not taken any initial phase or phase difference because we know if the two waves are having different frequencies, their phase difference periodically varies with time. So, we should not take any phase difference because it is continuously changing. Now, in this situation, after superposition, at a point, the resulting displacement can be given as y1 plus y2, which is, if you just add the two expressions, that will be sine of 2 pi n1t plus sine of 2 pi n2t. Now, if the two are added by using the trigonometric rule of addition of two sinusoidal terms, this will become 2a cos of 2 pi n1 minus n2 t by 2 multiplied by sine of 2 pi n1 plus n2 by 2 t. This is the expression we'll be getting after adding the two terms. And here you can see this n1 plus n2 by 2 is the frequency which is the average of the two and this is the difference. So, this whole term which is varying with time at relatively very low frequency, we can write it as r. So, this will be r sine of 2 pi n1 plus n2 by 2 t. This is the resulting displacement of a medium particle. We can see this medium particle is oscillating with the frequency which is average of the two frequencies and r is the amplitude of oscillation which is also dependent on time. So, we can see this is an equation of SHM which is having frequency is average of omega 1 and omega 2. And we can see the amplitude of oscillation r is written as 2a cos of 2 pi n1 minus n2 by 2 t. Here you can see r is varying periodically with time because it depends on a sinusoidal function. So, it is repeating itself after a period of time. So, we can say it periodically changes, which we already discussed theoretically in the definition of beats, that beats are basically the phenomena of a sound which is produced by superposition of two slightly different frequencies when the amplitude of oscillation varies periodically. Here we are getting the same mathematically. The same can be further analyzed for the rate at which the amplitude is changing or the frequency at which it is changing. Let's calculate it. As we have calculated, the variation of amplitude is given by this expression in case of beats. So, here we can say r is maximum when cos of 2 pi n1 minus n2 by 2 t is equals to plus minus of 1. So, this will give us 2 pi n1 minus n2 by 2 t should be equals to n pi. In the situation, this pi gets cancelled out, 2 gets cancelled out. The time instance at which the r will become maximum is capital N by N1 minus N2. Here N belongs to a set of integers which can be taken as 1, 2, 3, 4. This implies here we can say at time instance T is equal to 0, 1 by N1 minus N2, 2 by N1 minus N2 and so on sound will be maximum. As the amplitude is maximum, loudness will also be maximum. So these are the points where, these are the time instants when the resulting sound loudness will be maximum. Similarly, we can find R will be minimum 1 in this expression, this cos of 2 pi n1 minus n2 by 2 into t is equals to 0. And this will be 0 when 2 pi n1 minus n2 by 2 t is equals to 2n plus 1 pi by 2. When it is odd multiple of pi by 2, the cosine function will be 0 here. Pi gets cancelled out. And you can see this implies the value of time instant we are getting is 2n plus 1 by twice of n1 minus n2. And this implies at instance t is equal to, if we substitute n equals to 0, 1, 2, 3, it is 1 by twice of n1 minus n2, 3 by twice of n1 minus n2, and so on. Sound will be minimum. So here you can have a look very carefully that these time instants where sound is minimum are exactly located midway between the instant when sound was maximum. So after 0 and 1 by n1 minus n2, 1 by twice of n1 minus n2 is the exact instant of these two positions when it is maximum. This showed periodically sound is becoming maximum, minimum, or waxing and waning of sound is continuously taking place. Here we can also calculate the time difference between two maxima. If we calculate the difference, time period of beats, which we can call, this is called period of beats. Here this can be calculated as the difference of two maxima, it is 1 by n1 minus n2. Similarly, here also we can find out the period of beats. The difference of two minima is also same. It is 1 by n1 minus n2. Using this, we can find out the beat frequency also. Let's see that. So, in sequence, if we calculate the beat period can be simply written as the time between two successive maxima or minima, which we have just now calculated as it is 1 by n1 minus n2. Now, if we talk about beat frequency can be written as the frequency at which the amplitude is varying, or it can be written as number of beats produced per second. So, for number of beats produced per second, we can state this can be written as reciprocal of beat period. This beat frequency we can write here, it is n1 minus n2. It is the frequency difference of the two waves which are superposing. This is the rate at which the beats are being produced. If we just talk about a beat is composed of one maxima and one minima. This we term as one beat.